A drop of water is worth more than a sack of gold to a thirsty man. Water is an essential part of life and a very precious resource. It is a fact that Earth consists of only 70% water, and only 4% of this is available for us to drink. And this 4% is rapidly depleting. People say that precaution is better than any cure, and it is still not too late to change our ways. Have you ever wondered of an Earth without any water? To talk about such a possible future, here is Nanak to talk on Earth without water.
Earth without water. Water is the most important element in life because water is what keeps us alive. There is an endless use of water, so it is hard to imagine a life without water. We heavily depend on it to survive. Water is life. Hence, if there is no water, there is no life. In most cases, it is water that determines the human settlement. And without water, we could not have witnessed the Egyptian civilization. Even in the ancient periods of Rome, snow was used to pack prawns and meat. Many people think that there is plenty of water in the world because half of the earth is filled with water. Man rarely thinks of preserving water because all he needs to do is turn on the tap and he has water. Have you ever imagined life without water, where there is no water for shaving, brushing, or bathing in the morning like we are used to? That is why we need to preserve water, because it is the only way we humans can survive on this earth. As the human population increases, the need for water resources also increases. Thus, the next logical step is to preserve water to meet our future needs.
Only when the well is dry do we realize the worth of water. Why must we wait until nothing can be done? So, here is Jagriti to suggest ways to conserve water.
Thousands have lived without love, not one without water. Today, I would like to indicate some points on ways to conserve water. Of course, no water, no life. As it is becoming worse because of the pollution and climatic change, water conservation is a perfect way to improve the quality of water as well as to balance the current and future water needs. It is very easy to say that we should conserve, we should save water. But how many of us actually do it? Without proper implementation, we cannot expect any change in the state of water. There are a number of ways one can do in order to preserve water. With this point, we can all choose to practice the simple ways that each family can practice at home. For example, we can wash our fruits or vegetables in a bowl of water rather than running the tap. Or we could adjust our sprinkler so that only our plants get watered. Another way we can always do is by turning off the faucets while brushing our teeth and save 25 gallons of water. To reuse water also contributes a lot to conserve water. For instance, when we wash our fruits, dishes or vegetables, we can use the exact same water to water our plants. Or we could collect water from the roof to water our garden. There are many more ways we can do to reuse and conserve water. Someone rightly said, we never know the worth of water till the well is dry. So let us begin this journey of conserving water and not pollute or damage it anymore. Otherwise, the day won't be far when water turns from a necessity into a luxury. If we do not start now, we will never make it out. For better future and for better generations, let us all start conserving water, as there are a number of ways of conserving water and they all start with you. Thank you.